What's up, everybody?
Salad, what's up, man? Ahoy!
Today I'm working on pixel art for the hero. Meaning to touch this up, because I haven't touched the pixel art for Rock. You've been camping? How's it been? I haven't touched this pixel art in a long, long, long time. So, and I've been nervous too, because there's something like 212 or something like that. Individual PSD files and like 1500 different frames just for the hero. But it's about time. As you can tell, I'm gonna already made him so he pops a lot more right there. So here's what he looks like, or used to look like, and here's what he kind of looks like now. So you can see there's a lot more contrast. He doesn't blend into the background as much anymore. Got a lot more poppiness too. This is there's so many. What I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna keep on. I've been experimenting with this every single day this week. Like, I'll try something else. I've been trying to like do this and that. It looks like it's really weird when the inside the PSD files here, he looks super duper dark. But when you put him in the game and he's underneath the lights, because he's the one in the middle of the light almost all the time, so he's always brighter than he is here in the pixel art. Yeah, I know, right? He looks super duper tan here, but as you can see in the game, it wasn't. He didn't look like this in the game. So anyways, that's kind of one of the tricks of lighting. It's just kind of playing into it. You can see the dark edge of his sword is a lot darker than it used to be. So that really helps the sword pop. The sword doesn't look too bright. All, you know, super duper glowing. It's only that one half of it that's glowing, so it looks a lot better. His eyes are slightly brighter. It's weird, you can see it here. If I turn on off the saturation. Yeah, I want him to look like that. I definitely want him to be a little bit less pale. If you check this out, this is kind of weird, right? If you turn off this saturation thing, his eyes all look about the same, all of the pixels for his eyes. But if you turn on this saturation, you can see, whoa, there's a huge difference between that and that. So this is really helping to kind of focus on the way the art pops by just doing this. So one thing I want to try today is trying a completely different top hat and pants. So I'm going to do... I'm gonna focus on the brightness for that. Okay, so we'll start with. You can see the difference. And check it out in the game, you can really, really tell. The game takes these corner pixels here and lights them up with the bloom shader, but the other two pixels it doesn't. So it creates a really interesting effect with his eyes. So right there, you can't really see, his eyes aren't even glowing at all. But if I go to this, so you can see the corners of his eyes are glowing now, but not the middle. So that kind of like plays to the game's bloom shader. And then also there's this. Working on trying out some different hairstyles. So he's actually got a long ponytail or whatever and sort of like a mohawk going on. So I've tried so many different hairstyles just to try some new stuff out. Yeah, it is. Yeah, yellow's a really bright hue. So I kind of like this with a really, really bright mohawk like that, because it really helps him pop even more. It's a rock hawk. Yeah. So I'm gonna try doing a brighter top hat today, because when he takes off his hat like that and he does this bright mohawk, it looks pretty cool. It really makes him kind of unique and distinct, even though he kind of looks cool with the top hat too. I just want to see what it would look like with a brighter top hat. So I've tried a lot of things. I've tried different body colors. I tried them with blue skin, purple skin, green skin, all weird types of things. And I like this the best with this sort of like tan, reddish skin. But anyways, let's try this top hat. That's why the top hat doesn't fall off. Right. All right. Easiest thing to do is just to try it with some hue adjustments. You think it works? That's good. Good, good. I'm glad. It's good to get another opinion on this because I'm like, every day I'll only do this for like an hour a day and then come back to it the next day with a fresh perspective. And it's helping to do it that way because this is such a lot of PSD files to tinker with that I want to make sure I get this right. So if I have to tinker with this for a whole week before I actually commit to doing all 200 files, so be it. It's much better than making all these changes and then going, oh, it would have been so cool if I had just done that, you know? All right, so let's see what it looks like with the top hat being a lot brighter. Yeah, see, instantly he loses his contrast with the background. But if it was like a lot whiter, this looks so funny. Wow. Yeah, definitely, definitely. Getting used to it, yeah. So no disco, right? But so okay, the question is, right, I know this looks weird, but it's simply an experiment. What will it look like in the game with him with brighter hat, brighter pants? Well, does it make him pop more in the game, or does he just look worse? That looks horrible, man. First of all, it's too bright, but it just doesn't work at all. Let's try a little less bright. Stop wrenching things up. What's up, Wiseman? It totally clashes. It's really bad. Okay, so that's a little less bright. What was that? 45? Okay, once again, I don't think this is... I just wanted to try this because, like, it was on my mind. I'm like, if I don't try that, and I go and do 200 files, you know what I mean? There's no way to quickly undo that. So, yeah, I just wanted to try this. I'm going to try anything that's radical. Like, changing his skin color was a radical thing, but, like, I tried it. I didn't like it. Jib's Discotheque. it certainly makes him more visible. His legs are more visible, that's for sure. The top hat's kind of... So I don't like the top hat like that at all. The top hat actually works pretty good. It doesn't really blend into the background as much, but his pants... His pants certainly do. Maybe I'll try just brightening up his pants. Let's turn that off. And that... Okay, good. Yeah, that doesn't really change the its contrast that much with the background. Chaps or something now. Definitely too much. Yeah, right? What did I tell you about the assless chaps, huh? Last time you gave me your word, you wouldn't wear them again. You've gone one step too far. Too sexy. I'm too sexy for my pants. Too sexy for my pants. Too sexy. I got ants. Little touches here and there till it gets like, till I settle and finally go, okay, that's it. That's all the touches I could give it. That's all I can do. And then I'll run the script to modify 200 files. And then I'm gonna have to go into every single one of those 200 files, every single one of the frames and all of those 200 files, and update it all because now he's got some new stuff, like he's got a belt. He's got hair. That's better. Like it better compared to the old version, or just the little touches so far today? Yeah, there's a little bit of a backlighting. It makes the inside of them is darker. Oh yeah, and also yeah, you're right, that highlights, those highlights actually kind of make it brighter or look more like a backlight as well. Yeah, it does, right? It does. Without changing the color of the pants at all, it just helps it pop off the screen a little bit more. I think his legs are a little too skinny there. Compared to the original and anything you try on the stream. Oh, okay, cool. Good. Thank you for the feedback. This is definitely helping. Wonder what it'll look like with this one little pixel right there near his knee being brighter. Doesn't quite work. I guess this particular frame here, this pose, I guess you could call it, doesn't necessarily need. A lot more brightness. Maybe that pixel. Let's try it like that. Oh, that works. Cool. Just a couple little pixels to help his legs look a little more distinct versus the background. Oh, I don't like that pixel there now. These two are really getting to me. They're bugging me. You know what? I'm pretty happy with this. If this was it, we could call this good. Be happy with it. Let's check it out. On the overworld. What's up, at Rocket Bunny? How's it going, man? Will he be wearing a tux? Maybe for one scene he will wear a tux. See, you could especially see the difference in the contrast here. Like, if I go back to this, his skin is almost the same color as the ground there. So that just looks a little bit better. And you can see his legs very distinctly. It's kind of, oh, it's his shadow right behind him. I'm like, what is that? Okay, I'm happy with that. Just checking that so far. Yeah, right. I was scared of his shadow. I was like, what's that? Okay. Now, the next thing I want to do is prepare a script, which will take, because this is like 200 files or something I'll have to edit. But I wrote a script last time I had to edit Rock. And I'm going to do that same kind of script to do most of the work for me. So I'll take the colors of his skin, and the edge of the sword and things like that. I'll be able to process most of the artwork's coloring and stuff with this script. So I got to remember how I did that script. I think I did I think it was Scripps image processor. Yeah, and here's this rock darker thing I wrote. Ah. Okay, well, one thing I gotta do is restore his PSD files. The bash script, right? It's not actually a, it's a, actually a Photoshop script, which is harder to work with than a bash script, but in the end it's worth it to get at least, you know, at least 50% of his pixels kind of done already. 'Cause if you do the math on this, right? If it takes me 3 minutes, let's say it takes me 5 minutes. Does it have a shebang? No, it doesn't have a shebang. Okay, so if it takes me 5 minutes per, that's like 210 files, that's like 1,000 minutes, which is, it'll take me 17 and a half hours. I know, best name for a line of code ever, right? And if it only takes me 3 minutes, that's just saving 2 minutes per PSD file. That's only 10 hours compared to 17 hours. So, anyways, running this script can really help. Could save me 8 hours of freaking, you know, hand cramping pixel art. All right. So I've got to find a point where I hadn't even modified rock at all. I go back to this commit, this is old enough. Okay, and then this latest commit, I touched all the files. L2 sword, east, north, and south. Oh, and I've also done idle hatless. I did. I touched all the files. Ah, good one. Good one. What's up, Super Positive? Thank you. Happy belated New Year to you too. How's your 2017 going so far? Huh? Okay, so now that I've got that, I can make a new folder and make a copy of all of Rock's art files so they're all at the old state. Actually, let's open up raw sprites shadow and just make sure that I did get them all. Yeah, okay, so those three and that one. And this test file is not even needed. It's going pretty well. Nice. You're building a new computer? Sweet. Yeah. You play games on it? I need one. I need like a gaming computer. My laptop is just, it always overheats. Every Unity game out there makes my fan, the fan turn on my laptop. Oh, okay. I won't watch it on the stream. Okay, good. We got all the files. Copy raw sprites, shadow, rock. Oh, there's only 218 files. That's nothing. So there, I made a little folder with all the rocks. Files as they were before I changed it. So now Clayer. I can restore these files. Should be back to normal. Yeah. Is it mineral oil cooled? Okay, so now I need, basically I need to turn these edits to his sprite into an action to start with. So here's the rock darker action. It selects the color range, does some hue saturation and some brightness contrast. Whoa, they submerge it in mineral oil? Wow. That might work. It might work better for this computer to be submerged in mineral oil. Okay, let's start with this one. Idle 2, Sword South. And I'll need to make some kind of, here, let's make a copy of that just so I've got like a backup. There we go. And then rock idle to Sword South there. Wow. Really? Linus. 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 Linus Torvalds. Okay, so now I got both these open. Whoops. Okay, I can start recording an action. Linus, oh. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm wrong. But I thought I heard this one, this audio clip of him saying, "How do you pronounce Linux?" And he's like, "My name is Linus Torvalds, and I pronounce Linux as Linux." Maybe I'm wrong. Oh, it's a different Linus. Oh, okay, all right. Linus Tech Tips. I don't even know what that is. Shows you what I know. Think if I call this the same thing, it might be easier to run the script. I forgot to tweet. Oh, whoops. Thanks for reminding me. Oh, okay. All right. Tech tips, huh? Windows security sucks. Of course it does. I gotta check this guy out. Is he funny? Hope he's funny. I like funny people. Okay, so I'm gonna start converting all these colors and recording actions to do that. Let's do this. So I'm recording an action. I need to be on the right layer. Shit. Stop recording the action. Am I on the right layer? No, I'm not. There, now I'm on the right layer. He's funny, nice. Dick jokes. Oh, great. All right, so I need to select a color range. Want to do that color. Zero fuzziness. All right. Don't count that as an action. Oh, it just set my foreground color. Oh, that's good. That's all I wanted to do. Set foreground color, and then swap background foreground. Yep, and then delete. Shit, that didn't work. I wanted to fill with the background color. They teach users how to hide porn. Okay, delete the delete action. Undo. Okay, we've got this color. I want to change it to that color. How would I fill everything? I swear, pressing delete. Oh, is it this kind of delete? No. That delete? No. This used to work. You press delete and it fills it with the background color. Maybe if I just do. Fill. Oh, and not contiguous. There we go. Still didn't work. You gotta click in the. You gotta freaking. Wait. Let's see if this works. If I go. Fill. What does this do for its fill properties here? Fill from 21 pixels, 30. See, it's giving it an exact location. It's not going to work for every script. I need to come up with a freaking universal way to fill a color. They're not hinting at another game? Those bastards. Wait, what if we did all layers? Still requires an exact pixel location. That's not going to work. Okay. Got to find a way to fill those pixels. Is there... I know you can select a color range. Try pronouncing Jan Willem Nijman. Is it close? Hey, there's a really hard one to pronounce. Shoot, what's that name? Yeah, photos. I know. There's got to be some way. There's got to be some way. Jan Willem Nijman. Oh. There's another one. Oh, let me look this up. Members of Noisia. Here it is. Nick Roos, right? That's close. Oh, we got, did I get that one right? But this one, Martin van Sonderen. But this is the one that really gets me. Is it Thijs? Thijs? Or Thijs? How do you say that? This is like some of my favorite musicians in the whole world right here. These guys are freaking awesome. I love Noisia. Martin? Or Martin? I love how you're helping me. This is great. I like it. I want to know how to pronounce people's names right. I could have sworn. You can just press the delete key and it would fill with the background color. Why is that not working anymore? Oh, maybe you have to select this tool. No? Mart YN? But what about Thijs? This one. Thijs? Thijs? Replace color? Oh, there. Replace color. Let's try that. Oh, man. Sorry. Don't mean to give you a headache. Oh, it's they just... Oh, sorry. Yeah. Probably can't see it that well on my screen. Okay, come on. This has got to work. It's got to work. Let's delete this and this. And this. Let's just go image. Let's try and record it. Image. Adjustments. Replace color. Replace that color with this color. You're fine. Tis? Wait, tis? Tis de Vliga. Tis. Tis de Vliga? I like it, man. Your language is great. Okay, I guess there's no way to change it. So I'll have to look up this color first. Let's just call him Ty. Ty. Oh, Ty's? Ty's de Vliga? Is that right? Ty's de Vliga. So that's AB622C. Still recording? No, 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 no. Stop recording. Start recording. Image. Replace color. Match that. Replace with this. Oh my God, did that work? I'm gonna go yell at traffic. All right, man. See ya. Yeah, but without the S. Oh, just Ty. Ty de Vliga. I know, right? You can't just say it. Ty de Vliga. Ty. This is Ty. Ty de Vliga. All right, this looks like it worked. Replace color. Let's proceed. Yay! I got one. All right, so let's change that color now. 8D4F22. Record image. Replace color. Okay, so we're going to replace that color with this. Yes! Whenever you see an IJ, it sounds like the word I. Or, yeah, okay. So IJ is thigh, tie. And the TH, you just ignore the H. Right? So it's like the TH just sounds like a T. Oh. Martine. Oh, so it's Martine Gerritsen. And this is Martine as well. Martine van Sonderen. Martine and Ty. So you ignore the S as well. It's like a silent S. Are all your S's silent? Obviously not, there's Sonderen. But if it ends with an S, is it always silent? Oh, okay. Let's do that color. Not always, not always. Oh, the not always rule. Dang, those always get me in a language. I'm like, wait, I can't do this all the time. Oh, special cases, gotta learn everything specifically. Okay, let's do another replace color because that didn't work for this bottom one. This must just be slightly different. Yeah, Dutch too has special cases. Yeah, I know, right? Every language just seems like has their special cases. Right? Can you think of a single language that doesn't? Probably not. I really like Spanish is pretty neat how it, whoops, hold on. Spanish is pretty neat how it has some really, really like, its rules are pretty, there's a lot less special cases, it seems like, in Spanish. Yeah, yeah, uh-huh. Like, for example, in Spanish, Your vowels are always pronounced the same, which is really helpful, right? Yeah, yeah. The romantic languages. So wait, we're gonna change this color now. Record. Change that color to this color. Looking good. Looking good, kid. We still gotta change that color. Mm-hmm. Hopefully this color wasn't already changed. Because it looks like those two are almost exactly the same now. Bwah, bwah, bwah. Let's see if it works. So I want to replace another color. Change that. Yeah, see, that's going to change all these to that. Okay, that didn't work. But I think if we can move this up to the beginning, it might work. And then there's Latin. Right? Now into a more deep question. If you were to isolate one water molecule, would that molecule still be fluid? That's such a good question. Wow, I have no idea. Huh. Wow, that's a great question. I love science. Semantics, eh? Okay, so this dark color here is also going to change. What? Want that color. Yeah. Your teachers didn't believe you. You're like, suck it, look at this. I can do it. Didn't change right. Oh. Why? Why didn't this color change right? Oh, that's maddening. Oh. Oh man, I don't know. Bash counts. Bash is a crazy language. Vim itself is a language. Okay, so let's do this pixel next. We'll change it to that. They are, but they're all languages, are they not? They're all languages. Okay, good. We got, looks like one color left to do. Lighter Thief, what's up, man? Same hero. Same hero, just doing some changes, some touches ups. Rock got a wicked tan. I know it looks like he's wicked tan, right? In this, in the pixel art here, but when the in the game, the lighting changes him completely, so he doesn't look so wicked tan. Let me show you what I mean. So that's what he used to look like. That's his skin color, and this is what he looks like now. So just touches up, touches to make him look more less pale. He looks super pale, right? Because all the lights are on him. And they whiten things out and bleach things. So it's Xerra, Ekzerra. So Lighter Thief, what I'm doing right now is I got 218 of these files to do, and each one of the files has at least 3 different frames, if not 30 or 40 different frames. There's so many frames, right? So 200 files, better contrast. Oh, you know what, dude, while you're here, shoot, tell me what you think. Yeah, please let me know what you think. Let's run it again. I've tried so many different things. I've tried hair. I've tried taking off the hair. Yeah, I know. 200 files. It's like 1500 different frames. So it's a mysterious, blisteringly hot planet where everybody gets tan instantly. So, Lighter Thief, I'd really love to get your thoughts here. Like, here's him versus the background, right? Here's what he used to look like. Right? Here's what he looks like now. I'm trying hair, so that red, those few red pixels there are supposed to be hair. That's kind of an experiment. I might take off the hair and go back to a short hair look. Oh, here's what he looks like with his hat off right now. I'm trying an orange mohawk. An orange mohawk with a long, like, ponytail type thing in the back. What's up, HD? There's no ozone layer. Exactly. What's up, HD? How you doing, man? So I'm definitely looking for any kind of feedback. You like the Mohawk? That's cool. Right on. Okay, so right here's the new. Here's the road. Yeah. Right? You can tell there's a lot more contrast in every little bit of him here. You can see it pretty well too when it's in the dungeon. Rock a Gingy. It's a pretty sounds like you're about to go rock some club called the Gingy. See, especially here in the dungeon, you can really see pretty clearly. The mohawk really pops, makes him like kind of pop off the screen. I don't know. I'm definitely looking for thoughts here. Not so sure on the red hair, it's been unclear its hair. Yeah. Shorten it. Good, good. Oh, good. I'm glad you like the dark skin. So that's like, so far I'm writing a little script to try and do most of the work of converting all 200 of those sprites. So it'll basically convert his skin color mostly. And you can see there's like some other little touches. Like, let's go back to that. Sword South. Yeah, I'm not so sure about the hair either. So here I've got so many different. Wait, where are they? Oh, it's in the hatless one. But yeah, you can see that there's the belt now has changed. There's some highlighted pixels here on the sides of his pants that really help it pop more. The top hat has a lot more highlights to it as well. And also the sword. You can see the sword has really clear, distinct, bright bits and really dark bits. So it really contrasts a lot better. Yep, I've been experimenting with changes here to rock all this week. Every one of the days I've worked this week, I've done like an hour and like experimented. And now I'm finally ready to start committing to these experimental changes. All right, so yeah, here's what the. I tried so many different hairstyles. Here's like. There's like shorter on top. There's like where it was all red. There's like black hair. There's him kind of looking to the side or something, but I like the one with the mohawk the best. Let's try it right now, actually, without the red hair in the back. It's kind of a crisper, cleaner, more distinct look, I think. Let's see what that looks like in the game. It's a Brohawk, yeah. What's up, Rega? It looked like a cape. Yeah, it's so hard to see what it is. And especially from the back. Let's go to idle two sword north. From the back with his top hat on, especially, you can't really tell what it is. So let's try this out without the hair. And if he's gonna have a mohawk, I was thinking he would have it. Actually, the back of his head would just be the bottom part of the back of his head would be totally just skin. So let's make that skin color. Little darker though. Yeah. Rock Hawk, yeah. You want to give him a mullet? Well, that's kind of what it. Well, let's do that actually. We could give him sort of like a the back of his mohawk could come all the way down. So we need this color. If you do hair, it should be instantly recognizable. Yeah, which is why the mohawk works so good. Yeah. On this resolution, every pixel is. Yes, totally. Yeah, the total silhouette, that's the thing, right? With the hair, it doesn't change the total silhouette, so it's not as instantly recognizable. But the mohawk does with his hat off. So let's see what it looks like with like a real bright patch back there, but let's make this top bit here a lot darker under the hat. Yeah. I know I love the skin changes, the sword changes, the top hat changes, the belt. It's just the hair. I'm debating about the hair right now. All right, so let's go a little darker hue, little more saturated. And then maybe not quite as bright for this bottom bit. Huh, maybe just actually keeping it all the same color. Nah. An afro? Oh, that's worth experimenting with. That's definitely worth experimenting with. Let's try that. Well, let me finish this first, though. This needs to be a little darker. So that's supposed to be the back of his mohawk. But it makes him look like he has a freaking face, almost. I don't like it. I don't like it. There, that kind of gives him the impression that he has hair. But he doesn't. Okay. I'll leave it like that. Maybe the player could customize Rock at the start of the world. Use a shader to change the colors. I can't make that big of changes to the game at this point. I mean, I could, but it would take another 6 months. The things I would do if I really had a few more years to make this game, but I can't go a few more years. That would be so bad. That would be so bad of me. Right, so there. That's a look without hair in the back. Let's try a fro. Why not? Let's experiment with this. Yes, definitely something to chew on for volume two. Definitely. Yeah. Right? When it comes to the next game, I could start over and be like, okay, what do I want to add to this game that I couldn't put in the last one? The popcorn. It wasn't enough for him to dig around. It's bright blue. Now he's got blue popcorn. Oh, Rega. Yeah, he's a good point there. Very good point. Yeah. I would like to use procedural animation in the next game, though. So instead of me hand editing every one of these frames, I would make it all the sprites actually 3D models, but it would still get rendered as pixel art. It would look exactly like this, except that each pixel would be its own little point in a 3D space. And that way I can, as the character moves, it's like perfect. Even if it's running at 90 frames a second, it could do 90 frames a second of like super fluid animations and everything. Okay, let's try a mohawk, or I mean a fro. Fro time. Let's see what it looks like. I'm curious. Very curious here. Whoa, it's almost too much. This is like a super messy version. Okay, there's some weird pixels here because of this. It's Goku. Right, like customizing Link or Mario, good point. Right? This is so Goku right here. Very, very Goku. Okay, but these one pixels are messing with it all here. This bit that's on the top of the skin. I think I just need to apply these skin color changes. It's over 9,000. There is. You got to get all the screams. There we go. There we go. Okay, so now we can do just this hair. Oh my God. Okay, so I'm not liking this, but I'm gonna try and do it at least. I'm gonna put it in the game, see what happens. Oh yeah, Dragon Ball Original. What about a perfect sphere? Let's try it. It would be kind of space balls, wouldn't it? Space balls. Ah. What? This is funny. It's actually better to do a perfect sphere like this, actually. It looks better. Looks like a cheese ball. Cornrows? Right? Belle's got more of like a her hair looks more like this. It's like really tall. I think I like him better with the mohawk, but this is so funny to try. Just to like think of this like popping out of his top hat. He's got a top hat and then he takes it off and like poof. There's that. A rainbow clown wig? Okay, I'll try it. I'll try it. No idea left unturned. It's over 9,000. Whoops. Okay, let's see how that looks. Huh? Let's see how it looks. You beheaded him. I know I'm a bastard. Yeah. Over 9,000 layers. Right? I've already got 9,000 layers. 8,900 of them are just different faces and hairs. Oh my god, that's so funny. Wow. It's totally funny, right? It's totally funny to like see him take off his hat and like poof. I don't know. I don't know. This is so funny. I kind of almost want to do it. I haven't done any of the other art yet, so it's not, he's only gonna be like these couple frames I can do it, but look at that. Wow, I don't know what to do. Yeah, his eyes is made to glue. Do we? Okay, let's try the rainbow. Because rainbow clown wigs are awesome. I'm not crying, it's just so beautiful. What's up, Pithlix? Sorry if I said your name wrong. Okay, so rainbow wig, hair, afro. Let's give it a shot. Why not? What could go wrong? Love some red. Definitely some yellow. Yeah. Yeah, Cyan, I know. We were just hearing that. Sue, I don't know who you guys are talking about though. Oh, right. Dragon Ball Z. Definitely. Okay, some green. Oh, yeah, we're doing this. We're doing this. Really, it's not the afterbirth. I saw they were promoting it on Twitch the other day. They were promoting Binding of Isaac. Okay, let's see what this looks like in the game, because it's wild. Doesn't even look like hair in that much anymore. Almost looks like a helmet. I know it does seem easy, right? It's tough to get all of the. It's a beautiful art form. I love pixel art because it's so challenging. You have to try and express something with so few pixels. So wait, what's different in the new Binding of Isaac DLC? Is it just the same? It's the same game, right? But just with more stuff, I imagine. That's ridiculous. It's funny to try him with the rainbow head, but now he doesn't look like he's even where it has hair on. It looks like a helmet too much. Okay, anyways, we tried that. Let's try this with some a different color hair maybe. Oh, you can mod it, really? Most of the reviews are negative. Oh, it makes it harder. Huh. Wow, I didn't know that it would be that received that way. Whoa. Different unlockable skins for rocking. Oh my God. I was just mentioning this earlier. Yeah, that's something I would love to be able to do, and I would love to be able to change him depending on certain items you have. Like if you have another item, maybe you can get a feather in his top hat or something like that, but like it's 218 Photoshop files. That's not counting the number of frames in each file. So there's something like 1500 different hand pixeled frames and then 200 different individual files. So like there's just no way I'm going to be able to do alternate skins for Songbringer 1. It's too much work. In the Hunger Games, randomize the hue. It's pretty hilarious, though, that he has a fro. Yeah, if I had modularized this, or if I took the week to a month to modularize it, maybe. But there's just so many other more important things I've got to do. Okay, so anyways, what do you guys think? Wait, where is this? Where's the original? Oh, that's the original right there. Okay, wait, so this one with the mohawk or this one with the fro? Mohawk or fro? I'm starting to straw poll. Sweet, thanks, Ishii. All right, give me your votes. I need some votes, Mohawk or Fro. Here's the Mohawk. Here, I'll copy all this so we got both of them. You like both though? Yeah, totally, right, Rega? Such a decision to make though. So here, I'll put them both on the same screen. Whoops. Here, I'll make this a Twitter too. I'll put this on Twitter so I get some more votes. The funny parts, the funny parts. How did I learn pixel art? I just learned by watching other people do it, pretty much. I watched a lot, a lot, a lot. I watched a whole year's worth of just speed art, like speed paintings, of all kinds of art. It wasn't all just pixel art, but I learned the process of how to do art basically just by watching other people. Mohawk has a comfortable lead, huh? Fairy gave him magical powers. This sounds like another game. I'm not even voting. Should I vote? I should vote, huh? My vote counts. Oh, Pithlix, another thing I did is let me show you. I did this thing called From Programmer to Artist. I did everything I did. Well, this is kind of my description of how I became a or learned pixel art. So maybe this helps too. Yeah, right. I think I kind of feel the same way. The Mohawk is just like is really just more feasible and believable. Whoa, dang, Mohawk has a serious lead. Yeah, totally, they do. They have some great pixel art tutorials. Saint 11, wow, I was so glad you mentioned Saint 11 and Bandygrass. Both those guys have been putting out a lot of different little pixel art tutorials. If you just go to their Twitters and then click on the media, I'm sure you'll find their little pixel art tutorials. And there's a lot of other great pixel art tutorials online all over the place. Okay,
So I'm gonna let that whole straw poll run for a little bit longer, and I'm gonna start working or finish working on the script, which will take 200 of these PSD files and change at least his skin color. So I won't have to do that much work. There'll be a lot of things I'll have to touch up. Like I have to redraw his belt, re-add some of these like highlight pixels to the sides of his legs. There's some darker pixels here. And the whole sword is different colored, and his eyes have different colors, and I'll need to redraw his hair with the all for all the hatless frames. But at least the skin will be done by this script. So let me finish working on that script while the whole straw poll's going on. I think I was working on this file here. Yeah, okay, so this is it. All right, and I had my actions open. I was replacing colors. I'm creating an action that I can run, which will replace all the colors of his skin. So, yeah, you voted right on. Yay. Okay, so there's this bit of color right there. It needs to be changed to that color. Okay, so copy that color. And go image adjustments, replace color, change that color to this color. Okay, good. Now his eye color needs to change. So I think it is, right? Let's see. This is his old color has a slightly different. This is 62, 63, 98. This 60, 86, 94. Totally different color. It looks like it's the same color, but the saturation is completely different. And if you turn on a hue saturation, you'll be able to see. Oh, I forgot to record that last bit. Damn thanks, Lighter Thief. Thank you for your feedback so much. I look up to you, Lighter Thief. Lighter Thief's pixel art. That's another person to look at, Pithlix. Look at Lighter Thief's pixel art. That'll teach you a thing or two. He's a great artist. Good night, man. See you, Steve. Okay, I'm gonna need to record this action. Let me see. You're gonna need that color. Record. Change this color to that color. And this time we got it recorded. Sweet. I can stop. Now I need to change his eyes to be this color. Okay, so that's the color I want it to be. FOFO22. Start recording. Adjustments, replace color. Replace that color with this. Whoa, what? That's not right. Another instance of the color not being how I meant it to be. Wait a minute. All of these colors are wrong. Do I have any other projects in mind after Songbringer? What's up, Flying Zombie? Yes, I actually am going to do Songbringer 2. Songbringer 2 and 3. They won't actually be called Songbringer 2 and Songbringer 3, but they will be, yeah, I have a lot of plans for the continuation of this story. But I would like to do some other games. Maybe I'll throw in like a small game in between. I don't know, maybe something else. It's a $20 course. Oh man, I just noticed this none of this is right. Right? Look at this color right here. This is different. This is 74411E. And this. Oh, it is the same color. Maybe it just looks like it's not the same color, but this is definitely wrong. This right here is A46B3B.
I didn't see that. 9D is totally different color. This one too. I guess I gotta start over. Damn it. Thank you, Flying Zombie. I appreciate you saying that. So that's AF7040. And this is tall. Oh, what happened? What happened? None of these are the right color. Oh. Let's try it again. There's this. I want to change this to FOFO22. Maybe if I'm not recording. Image adjustments, replace color, place that color with FOFO22. See, look at this, it's dark. Why is it dark? So maybe this just doesn't work. What if I put that at zero? What color does that give me? It's still not the right color. So brightness 94, saturation 86, hue 60, 98. So this is only a lightness change of minus 4. But here it gives me this lightness minus 13. Doesn't work. This doesn't give the exact color. Not in every case. Can't use this. I can't use this to do this way. Damn it. Well, now I gotta find another way to replace colors for a script. Shit balls. That's just not at all the right color. Okay, well, I guess I gotta delete this entire action, all these actions. Revert this file. Well, apparently I saved it a while ago. Okay, close this file. Let's see how this is going, huh? Six votes for the Mohawk. Cool. All right, so we'll copy from rock to. Idle two sword. South. Starting over, starting over. Here we go. Okay, so I saved the file. All right, I'm thinking maybe I'll do a color selection and then where we gotta select the right frame. Start recording. Okay, so let's start with selecting this color. Well, let's do this color. Like the color range, that color. Okay, now set the current foreground color to this. Now, if I do a new layer, solid color, and then merge, will that action work? Select layer 0, the name 0. What? How am I gonna do this? Change, all I want to do is change the color. Making a new layer, this is on sounds super complicated. Okay. I'm gonna take a little break. I'll be right back. Think about what to do. Okay, idea. If I select this color range, and then I select, let's see, let's get this color. And then I use the pencil tool really big, right in the middle. That work? Oh, it doesn't record. Damn it, you can't select. Oh. All I want to do is change a freaking color. There's gotta be a way. There's gotta be a way. Yeah, nothing. I'm still trying to figure out how to change this color to be that color, and it work exactly, and then I can record it so that I can replay it. Yeah. Scripting issue. The issue is like I just explained. Yeah. So, anyways, let's select that color again. That time is selected. Ah, batch replace colors, huh? Oh, cool. Thank you, Salad. Try and write a script to replace the colors. Photoshop script to update the color of all shape and fill layers that are the same color as the currently selected layer. Is there a beta version out of Songbringer? Yeah. Yeah, you can play it yourself if you want. It's at songbringer.com/preorder. Songbringer.com/preorder. And there's two links. The $16 one gives you the game when it's finished, and the $32 one gives you the game right now. You get a key. Yeah, this is cool. This is like, 'cause I am gonna use a script too, but I know how to kind of work with scripts, but I'm not sure how to, all their scripts exactly work. But the way my script worked before to do it last time is I did an action first. So I recorded an action and then my script worked for every file and then it just played that action. So I don't know if this will work because this is all about shape and fill layers, but I am going to save a link to this. 'Cause this might help for the last step of it all. There's got to be some just effect that just changes a color to an exact different color. What's this selective color thing? The hell? What? Am I in the wrong layer? Oh, I probably am. No, oh, I was on the wrong layer the whole time. All right. Color range. That's the background color. All right, see you, HD. Later. Have a good one, man. So that color range, that color. Selective color. What? What does this do? This isn't working. Says you're buying art. Here you go. You can make art like this. It's not that hard. What's up, Fiendry? Hello, man. My day's going good. How about you? It's got to be something. Variables? Adjustments. Too bad replace color doesn't replace exactly with the right color. That would be so easy. It'd be too easy though. Far too easy. This should be a pretty simple thing, just to change one color to another color. In fact, why can't I use the delete key to fill it with the background color? That would be so simple. Cool, man. It's an 8-hour course, huh? Oh, command delete or option delete? Really? Okay, let's try that. Here's the color. I'm gonna go option delete. What? It worked. Okay, let's see if it please be able to record this. Oh my God, please. All right, select color range, that color. Set the foreground color, command delete. Phil, it worked, but don't tell me. Oh my God, it worked. Oh, yes. Yes. Finally, a deterministic way to set a color exactly to another color. Oh my god, yes! Yes! Continue doing this. Record. I want to select this color. I want to set this to be my foreground color. And I want to go Command Delete. Shit, it didn't work. What? Let's try it again. All right, one more time. Come on. Image. No, select color range. That color. Set foreground color. Command delete. What? What the fuck? Rocket teaches Wiz random touch shit. All right. Teach me, man. Teach me. I'm tired of these quirky quirks here in Photoshop. What the hell? Why is that not the right color? What the hell? This is 8D4F22. And it's a totally different color. Am I doing the wrong shortcut? Command delete for the foreground color. Why is this using the background color though? Set foreground color there. Record. Command delete. I just did command delete and it failed using the background color. Okay, what if I do option delete then? Oh, look, it uses the right color. Okay, so option delete it is. Oh, this was the wrong one. Fuck. Let's just start over. How many times have I started over today? My life is pain. You look like a rapist. thank you. What a great compliment. All right, okay, let's try this again. Whoops, no set selection. All right, starting with color range. This color. Now we select another color. Thanks, Flying Zombie. Okay, so the way they're doing it, this one is to use select color range, but then they do a new layer paint bucket. So the new layer paint bucket makes it really difficult for the scripts. I think this way is going to work a little better. Art being tart.
Aren't being tarred. Then don't rape. Just don't do any raping. Okay, select. Set the foreground color. Now option delete. Fills with the foreground color. Yes, okay, we got one color. One color done correctly. And just to verify this completely, right? AB622C is the color it should be. AB622C, yes! Oh, it's working so far. Okay, proceed. Select color range. Let's do this color now. Fill it with this color. Option, delete. That's some good wholesome goodness. Wait, I don't need to set selection to none. Let's see if it's working so far. Oh yeah, that totally worked. Oh, cake is just cake? Oh, what's tart then? So maybe I do need to set selection none. In here. So if I had a selection and I go record, set selection none, and then same thing here, record, set selection none. Okay, let's try playing that back again. Son of a bitch. Oh, nice. Oh, you gave me another one of your special cases, huh? All right, so I'm wondering what the hell happened here. Oh, it worked on the first color. Or did it? Maybe it didn't. Hold on, wait. What if we have both colors? Maybe it just didn't find that one color. Play. It does work. Oh, so if it can't find the color, then it's gonna mess up though. Shoot. Egg. What the hell happened here? Adobe happened. Court con Ardepple Nuker. Oh man. So this works. It sets the color exactly, but the problem is that if that color is missing, and yes, there are going to be some files where this doesn't work. It'll just fill the whole screen with that one color. It'll mess it all up.
Wait a minute. What if we do something like this? Like, we sneakily put in a selection. So we've got set selection to the top left pixel, and then do a color range. And if that color range fails, hopefully it will still have that other selection. And then set the foreground color, and then fill. So worst case, it would just make a tiny dot. Open in paint, that'd be a cool way to do it. If only it were that simple. Okay, so let's try that. This time he's got two of his colors changed. So if I run this, oh, it still fails. Yeah, you watched it in math class? Well, this isn't working. Damn. I might have to write a script that just does it by hand. Okay, so let's undo. I just want that color. And if I run this, yeah, it messes up. So this whole set selection in the top left corner, that doesn't help to like, 'cause if we have a color range, I wonder if there was a way to like make something if it succeeds. Like a Photoshop. If has selection. Okay, so there are some special actions y thingies. Actions panel menu. Insert a stop. Now, this is interesting. All right, Pith. See you, man. Path is only available when a path or shape is selected. So it's the actions panel here. So we've got insert stop, insert menu item, action options. But there's no way to like say if there's no selection, don't do a certain action. God, if only the freaking replace color thing worked. That would be ideal. But it doesn't work. Why doesn't it work? Just hide the layer. What do you mean? Make a duplicate and hide one? What would that accomplish? Yes, this is what's happening to me too. The replace color is not quite working. The tool replaces color, but in the manner that is similar to you adding a new color layer to set the color blend mode. The tool is just stupid. It doesn't work. Apparently, if you make the color dark first. It's worth a shot. Let's see if it works. All right, so let's start over. Kill that, even though I was so close to working that way. Damn. All right, so this time we're going to go... Oh man, if I select a color range and then make it dark. I guess I could replace it. Oh yeah, what if I replace with pure black first? Okay, let's try that. So image. Adjustments. Replace color, we'll take that. And replace it with pure black. It's purple. I want pure black. Okay. And now we go image, adjustments, replace color again, but this time I want to change it to be that color. So I want to change this color and make the result like that. Oh, lovely. It turned it pure gray. Photoshop. Photoshop. How the hell am I supposed to accurately change a color with a script? Okay, one more try. Maybe I'll try making it pure white or pure gray. Who the hell knows? One of these might work. Adjustments, replace color. I want it eventually to be like this. AB622C. Image, replace color. That color, replace it with pure white. Okay, so now we take pure white and replace it with this. Once again, it didn't work. It just did gray. God. Oh man, this might not even be possible. Let's try it again. This time we'll try changing it to saturation 0. And still it doesn't work. Just still gray. Even if I set the saturation at 100%. It's still gray. This replace colors thing is a piece of shit. It replaces the color with something close to the color that you wanted, but not quite. Not quite. All right. I could just hand pixel every single one of these frames. I'm telling you, that's like 17 hours worth of work at least. If it's 5 minutes per sprite file, that's hauling ass too. That's like repixeling so fast just to get 5 minutes per. I guess I'll have to take a look more at these scripts. To do something like this, maybe. But just to figure out how to do it on my own, like I look at the. I guess I could try doing another. Yeah, so if I tried to do it a different way where I used layers, right? I could make a selection and then create a new layer Oh, you know what? I know what I could do. This one way was really close to working. I'm sure it won't work for every single file, but what I could do is run it for all the files and then find the ones that it didn't work for and just like delete those. Dash jab. Sweet. I like how he got all flat there for a second. Okay, well, I guess that's the best solution there. So, actions, let's record some actions. Select color range. Whoops, forgot to record that one. Color range. Da, 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 Wizard Moon. What's that? Change it that color. What? I have two color ranges here. Ay, ay, ay. Oh, sweet. Nice. You played that right on. Yeah, that wasn't actually a finished game. That was just a game kit. I was gonna say, like, I thought you. I was like, what? Somebody released a game called Wizard Moon? Because that's something that I named a platformer kit thing. I thought somebody made a game that was actually called that. Okay, now we just got one color fill there. Now let's do the next one. Okay, getting there. Yeah, see, I can't really change the. If I try and change anything else, that there might be. This might not work. Right? Because what I really want to do is change this, the sword color, this color, and his eye color. But not every single one of the frames of his animations has all those, right? Some of them, he doesn't have the sword, so the whole thing will fail. Some things will not have his eye color, and that would fail too. So maybe it's just best to stick with this script being like that, where it just changes his skin color. Okay, let's see if that worked. Revert this file. That's how he was before. And now I'm going to try playing this action back. Select the right layer. Let's see what happens if I play this. Well, it. Shit! It broke. Oh. I don't know if scripting is going to work for this. Where did it go wrong? The second color, the second color failed. So if I take, if I, let's make a duplicate of this. Maybe you can't duplicate actions. Oh, there we go. You can option drag. Never give up. Thank you, man. Thank you. Thank you for saying that. I can't give up on this, right? I just don't want to have to hand pixel all these files. Okay, I tried deleting one of the color ranges. Still fails. Maybe it fails no matter what on the second color. Right here, I've got only two colors. Whoops. And it fails. But if I get rid of the everything but the first color. First color works. Okay, I just want to be able to do two colors at least. Let's see, two color. Delete all these. Maybe it needs a deselect. How long have I done pixel art? Only a couple years. I kind of started like in 2012. Oh, it needs a set selection. All right. Thanks for saying don't give up. See? Breakthrough happened. Okay, so in the middle of all these, there needs to be... set selection none. I don't know why there's two... Whoa, whoa, whoa! Oh, God, did you see that? That was Adobe Photoshop. Weirdness. Okay, so I have a selection, I record, I unselect, deselect, whatever. There, I got a set selection none. Now I can copy this to after each fill. All right, now I can undo those. All right, make sure the right layer is selected. Let's try this again. Play that action. It worked. Oh my God. Freaking worked. Oh, it's amazing. All right, well. Oh, there's that. Cool. So now what I need to do is go and play with the script file. Where I don't know where the hell I got this from, this rock darker thing, or I made some kind of script. I think I cached it somewhere, put it, stashed it, something, some folder. I'll find that. I'll need to make sure the script still applies correctly to all the current files. And then what I'll do is I'll run this script, and it'll probably take it like 20 minutes or something to just run over all of the files. But that's what I'm going to do. So... but first, I need to get a break. So thanks a lot for watching, everybody. And I hope y'all are having a nice 2017. And I'll catch y'all next time. Thanks again.